But first, federal parliament kicks off the election year tomorrow with Julia Gillard coming under pressure to bring Kevin Rudd back into her team. A dramatic reversal in news poll has nervous Labor MPs looking for all the help they can get to defeat a resurgent coalition.
Challenging times for new Attorney General Mark Dreyfus, thrown straight into dealing with summer's natural disasters. The government keen to be seen getting on with the job.
The Army is assisting with the recovery effort in southeast Queensland.
The ministerial reshuffle within days of the election date and the arrest of Craig Thomson, all cannon fodder for the opposition.
And it's been a disaster. Everything they've touched, it's almost like they try to create stuff up.
News poll has Labor slipping further behind, now a 12-point spread. Since the Prime Minister's misogyny speech helped Labor back to level pegging last October, the trend's been against the government. The collapse even starker in the head-to-head battle. Julia Gillard's double-digit lead as preferred Prime Minister has evaporated. She may be leaving the show, but Nicola Roxon remains doggedly hopeful.
Of course, Labor can win the election. I think we will win the election, and I think the community needs us to win the election.
Others say the party needs all the help it can get. Cue Kevin Rudd.
We need to engage Kevin Rudd and use him wherever.
But the former PM angered Gillard supporters, skipping caucus while promoting himself on YouTube.
And I think he is an asset and we should use him, but it has to be a disciplined asset.
Labor faces the new parliamentary session with cracks beginning to appear in caucus. The Prime Minister was forced today to warn her MPs to stay disciplined and united. Negative stories now being peddled in the media would only harm marginal seat holders and any government recovery.
Okay. All a gift for the opposition, but Tony Abbott warned his front bench to be wary of complacency, and he's promising voters to turn over a new leaf.
They want us not so much to be an opposition, but to be an alternative government.
Mr Abbott says the new positive strategy is already in place. The government will be looking for more evidence of it in question time tomorrow.
Well, Kelvin Thomson has been part of this reshuffle with a promotion to Parliamentary Secretary for Trade, and he joins me now from Canberra. Mr Thomson, congratulations on the new appointment. Horrendous polls today for Labor, now revelations of perhaps damaging leaks from within. Do you think this reshuffle is going to be enough to save Labor at the next election?
In terms of where we go in the future, I think what the public is looking for from both the government and the opposition is for us to be positive about the things that we've done and positive about the things that we're going to do. And I think that we've got a very good story to tell in that regard. We've got a good story to tell in relation to interest rates, inflation, employment, balancing the books, and we've got a good story to tell in relation to the future.
Good story to tell there, but you could scarcely have scripted a worse start to the year for the Prime Minister.
Well, I think that I know that there has been criticism of setting the election date, but I am a fan of the fixed-term parliaments, and I think that setting the election date will provide certainty for business and for the public sector, that it's in the nation's interest, and as the weeks and months unfold, people will realise that, and hopefully we will get a debate about policies and we will be able to talk about health and education and renewable energy and homelessness and all the sorts of things that are important for Australians rather than the negative kind of debate that we've had previously during this parliament.
We're starting to get renewed debate as well about the role of Kevin Rudd. Mr Thomson, do you think his popularity should be called upon again by Labor in the lead up to the election?
Kevin Rudd is a person of great ability and talent. I know that a number of caucus colleagues are seeking his assistance in relation to campaigning in their electorates. And of course, he is someone who's talented and the party will be making use of.
Would you like to see more of him in Labor's role in the lead up to September?
Well, he's made it clear that he's playing a role, and I welcome that, and my caucus colleagues welcome that. Now, the nature of that role is, of course, for him, but it's a positive role, and I think that it's something that everyone's appreciative of.
National Senate leader Barnaby Joyce has attacked your suitability for this role, given your stance on live exports and the associated tensions it caused with Indonesia. Has your stance changed?
As Parliamentary Secretary for Trade, it's my job to advance the government's policies, and when I meet with overseas officials or with companies and so on in discussing these issues, I will be promoting the government's policies. I am committed to animal welfare, and I believe that a strong commitment to animal welfare is certainly no disqualification from a role in government, in trade and other areas. The government has a strong commitment to animal welfare, and I believe that it is very much in the industry's interests that it displays a strong commitment to animal welfare, and I think it's wrong of Senator Joyce or others to imply otherwise.
Mr. Thomson, congratulations again. Thank you for your time.
Thank you very much.